Aloha one and all, and welcome to Punahou School for this afternoon's ILH Girls Varsity Softball game featuring the Kamehameha Schools Warriors and your Punahou Buff and Blue. We are here live. We're just getting underway. First batter up for the Kamehameha Schools Warriors, Malia Zablon. Kamehameha ranked number one in the state right now. Buff and Blue ranked, I believe, number five or six in the state poll. JC Young on the mound for the Buff and Blue. Last webcast we had here, she threw a no-hitter against a two-time defending state champion Mid-Pacific Institute Owls. And see if she can match that performance here again today against the very talented Kamehameha Schools team. And she takes, and Zablon takes for a strike. Beautiful day here on middle field. Buff and Blue currently 7-3. Zablon grounded to third, Heaven Long to first, one down for the Buff and Blue. And of course, I would be remiss if I didn't introduce my partner this afternoon, former Punahou softballer, Kelly Ishii. Kelly, thank you for joining me.
Absolutely, thank you for having me.
Glad to have you here. So we're at one away now, top of the first, and stepping to the plate for Kamehameha is number five, Caitlin Mahelona. Kamehameha has a very balanced team this year, three freshmen, four sophomores, three juniors, and four seniors. And they seem to have a real kind of, they found a way to build their program. You know, build, you know, get, keep inputting younger talent as they go.
Absolutely, Coach Aloha Kale Yamaguchi has been great in just keeping that, basically a good program all together, and that starts at the intermediate level. You can see that with their talent, and it's been pretty consistent throughout the years.
And there you see Heaven Wong getting the pop fly foul. Two down for Kamehameha, stepping to the plate, Christine Hippa, a sophomore. These two teams met earlier this year on March 11th, Kamehameha was victorious 1-0 on the Kapalama campus. She takes for ball one. Kamehameha is 10-0 on the year right now. 8-0, excuse me. Very tough team. Hit to second base, bounced to Va'a. She can't handle the throw. I think she may have beat that. Would you have given that a hit or an error?
I would have probably given a throwing error on the second baseman. It looks like she did do a little bit of a running throw on that play, but it was a very makeable play.
Right, Sumita looks like she had a little bit of trouble handling that.
Va'a with the good effort, though.
Doing what she can to dig it out. Of course, Vanessa Va'a, an all-state selection.
You know, she's been a real leader on this team, Vanessa Va'a. Talking to Coach Bobby Makahilahila, you can really tell that she was a staple of their team, really kind of the core of their defense and their offense.
Right, Atisha Norton at the plate now, cleanup hitter for the Warriors. One on swing and a miss for Norton.
That's a nice changeup, low outside. You can see that JC Young, the pitcher, is really mixing it up today, keeping so far the Kamehameha batters off balance.
Another example of that, struck out swinging.
Yep, that's a great example of really what you can do to throw the batters off early in the game, kind of take control of that defense, and we'll see what Punahou is able to do offensively in this next upcoming inning.
Right, of course, the Buff and Blue are 7-3 on the year with losses to, they've split with Maryknoll so far. They have one loss to Maryknoll, took a tough loss to Iolani here where they were kind of four-hit batters, multiple errors. They were just spraying the ball over the place. I'm certain they'd ask for that game back. And then, of course, they lost at Kamehameha 1-0 in a very tight game. I think five hits in the entire game.
Yep, you can tell that Punahou really wants this one. It is early in the game, but nonetheless, you could see it in their intensity and their workout. Everyone knew the really the importance of this game.
Well, of course, it's Punahou and Kamehameha, right?
You know,
it's not. It's, you know, everyone wants to. You know, everyone in the in the state wants to beat Punahou. And anytime Punahou plays Iolani or Kamehameha, the fans show up here. I mean, if you'll get at some point, you'll get to see a lot of people on folding chairs trying to grab pieces of shade all around here down both lines. Yeah. And there you see on the mound for Kamehameha, the pitcher, Kama Dung, a sophomore for Kamehameha. She was a winning pitcher the first time these teams met. And as I said, a very balanced team for the Warriors.
Yep. All around, I mean, they do have a few starting seniors, but ultimately it seems like they just are so balanced in their grades. You can tend to see throughout the season the experience level of some of these girls, but so far it seems like Kamehameha throughout the season has kept their composure. Again, 8-0 on the season. So.
Right. And getting ready to lead off for the Buff and Blue in the bottom of the first, Daylen Masada, the shortstop. She's having a great year.
Oh, no kidding.
She's having a great year, the senior.
Absolutely. She defensively is just something special as well, but the left-handed slapper over here, she can pop that ball into places that really the defenders can't get to a lot of the time.
Right. Took her first pitch for a strike.
There with the
dribbler down the first base line. I think that rolled foul. Yes, it did. 0-2 to Masada.
Even something as short as that can easily get her on base with that speed.
Well, that's the whole premise behind being the slap hitter, right? And sometimes players will learn to slap hit even if they're natural righties. Am I wrong on that?
No, absolutely correct. The slap is such an offensive threat. You know, you can drop the bunt from there. You can hit it a blooper over the shortstop's head. I mean, there's so many. You're such an offensive weapon, ultimately, that it's hard to defend any time around.
During our last broadcast, Nancy came up with this little fun fact that all polar bears were left-handed, and I had mused the idea that her husband would want to create a team of left-handed polar bears. There you see the slapper to second base, and Masada beats it out. Nice. Well done by Thalen Masada on the dribbler to second base.
Absolutely. Running through hard and never giving up. You can see how much they want it. Making basically lemonade out of lemons on that one.
Right. I mean, you don't have to hit the ball hard. You just need to get
on
there.
On the ground. Absolutely.
Right. And stepping to the plate for the Buff and Boo, Kylie Popovich, the catcher.
Right. So Kylie's younger sister, is that correct? Also plays on the team?
Yes, she does. Amber.
Great.
Kylie the senior, Amber the junior. Masada, she got back. She was trying to bait the throw there, I think, was debating going to second. But I referred to them plurally as Popovi.
Touche, pretty clever.
That's what they pay me for.
On that last pitch, Kylie showed bunt. Shows again.
Does a great job of advancing the runner, does Kylie Popovich, getting Masada down to second base.
Absolutely. That sacrifice bunt is crucial in tight games like these. Really just trying to advance the runners in any chance that they possibly can. Get them into scoring position. That's textbook play right there.
Textbook softball. Stepping to the plate for the Buff and Blue, Nicole Nishizawa, the designated player. She's a sophomore for the Buff and Blue. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Dung faking the throw back to second base, trying to keep Masada close.
That's crucial for the Kamehameha defense to keep Thalen Masada close to second. If they get a good outside pitch and the batter goes with it, ultimately Thalen's coming home with her speed.
Let's see here, two strikes on Nishizawa. She takes.
You know, a good, every coach has their thought process on what to do in the situation, but ultimately, as a good batter, you want to try and go opposite field with this ball. That way the play is behind your runner at second base.
Nishizawa strikes out swinging. Two down for the Buff and Blue. Bottom of the first. Daylen Masada on second on a dribbler to second base that she managed to leg out.
Absolutely. That was just impressive.
Yes, it was. Now our Punahou's all-stater, Vanessa Va'a, big swing for V and Masada.
Woo.
Very heads up, taking third. Kamehameha defense falling asleep a little bit.
It's a absolutely. That was a very heads-up play on Thalen Masada's part, noticing that the catcher's not being aggressive as she should be, getting the ball back to the pitcher as fast as possible.
V fouls it off, strike two. Vanessa's quite the singer, I understand. I know she's in her church choir, but I understand she just tore it up in the variety show this year.
Really?
Every year, you know, there's somebody who just kind of, whoa, where did that come from? Even if we knew you sing, but they just shine. And that was V this year, and she strikes out swinging. And that's three down for the Buff and Blue. Couldn't get Masada all the way around.
Yep, it looks like it's going to be a little bit of a pitcher's duel,
right?
Obviously. I mean, struck out two key players in that last inning, or bottom of the inning, so looking forward to see what's coming up next here.
Right, two strikeouts for Kama Dung of Kamehameha in the bottom of the first. Of course, talking to the coach, Coach Bobby Makahilahila, Punahou's coach beforehand, he couldn't speak enough of Kamehameha's athletes on the team.
Yeah.
Just top to bottom, he says, they're Kamehameha, they're always gonna have good athletes. And even as we were watching the warm-ups, you were commenting that their middles, I mean, that was exactly your words. Like, wow, they're really athletic.
Yeah, up the middle, they looked really strong. They have a few good players, I mean, a lot of good players to be exact, but just to see their technique, their strength, I mean, we're going to see a lot of that. And like we said, it's going to be a pitcher's duel, so that defense is going to be very, very crucial throughout the game. Not to discredit Punahou's defense as well. They've been pretty solid thus far. Just an early error, but nothing that they can't bounce back from.
Right. I was here for the Iolani game that they lost 4-2, and it certainly wasn't, I can't remember, it was like two or three errors on the play. I think there was like one earned run out of the four. Wasn't J.C. Young's best outing. I think she plunked three or four batters.
Oh, yeah.
So anytime you give another team another, you know, five, six outs, you're not going to win.
Exactly.
You're not going to win. Stepping to plate for Kamehameha, number 13, Akaya Naivi, a senior for the Warriors. She fouls that one off. See, Kamehameha, arguably one of the more storied programs in local softball. Not as dominant as they were in the 80s or possibly 90s. Another swing and a miss for Naivi. But they've won 8 state titles. The only other team with more is 10,
wow,
with Kailua. But in more recent years, if you... Naivi takes eye for a ball. In the last 10 years, 8 different teams have won the state title.
You know, that's not surprising at all. Just the talent all around the state is really, really phenomenal. So, you know, a lot of these girls play club ball together, but where they're from originally is much different. So to see that level of play in the state is really exciting.
Well, I think it bodes well for the talent in the state, and you look and see the amount of local talent that is choosing to stay home and is being developed locally by the UH coach like Bob Coolin and or even the D2 programs.
Absolutely. And, you know, speaking of... I guess a higher level in college. Aloha Yamaguchi's father is Kent Yamaguchi, and he's the head coach over at Chaminade. So,
mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm sure they do a little bit of a feeder
right.
system
coaches,
there.
Coaches' kids are always, you know, as the sport grows here, a sharp grounder down the third base line, foul. Nice hands. Go, coach. All right. Yeah, we were here a couple of weeks ago and we had one of the intermediate teams kind of better. And it wasn't, you know, sharp grounder over here. They all kind of hit. It's like, girls, you have a glove.
Yeah.
All right, Dung takes for a ball.
That's easy for us to say. We have a huge net in front
we
of
have
us.
Multiple, yes. I'd rather be safe than have.
Yeah. I've gotten hit by the ball enough times already, right. So my career is over. I'll be okay with that.
Right, and you... how many years did you play here?
I was a 4-year senior at Punahou, or 4-year.
4-year senior. They always stick around that
wow.
long.
That's impressive, isn't
wow,
it?
Wow, good job.
4-year varsity letterman at
right.
Punahou. So yeah, that was. I really enjoyed my time here. It was fantastic. Can't complain.
Right, but then you also went on to play in college, and Dung gets hit.
Hopefully,
that's the only one J.C. Young will give up today.
Absolutely, went a little bit too inside on that pitch. I'm sure she want that one back, but It's not a bad play. We can see what we can get from here. Maybe hopefully turn a double play.
One down here in the top of the second, stepping to the plate, Misty Ho'ohuli, a shortstop, senior for the Warriors.
You know, we're getting a little bit closer to the bottom of the lineup here, but Kamehameha always poses a threat from 1 to 9, so not anything to be taken easy on.
Right, so they put a pinch runner in at first for Dung, number 12, Tamara Hallams.
Hallams at speed on first.
We can assume. she's yeah,
quite possibly. But usually when they put in that pinch runner, it means that they're trying to, you know, maybe do a little bit more with it, a little hit and run, maybe lay down the bunt. Just make sure that they take advantage of this opportunity here.
So I think both coaches, you've seen early on the way they were trying to get Masada around the bases. They're trying really hard to manufacture runs because they anticipate this being a tight game.
Absolutely.
See, Ho'ohuli lays down the bunt to first base. Va'a gets there to first base for the out.
Yep.
Nicely executed on both sides.
Yep, that second baseman, Sumita, covering at first. So important for her to get over there on time.
Here you see stepping to the plate for the Warriors, Rachel Dumlau, the center fielder, with two down here in the top of the second. A wonderful day here on Rice Field. It's nice.
Middlefield?
Middlefield, yes. Yes. They have actual names. I had to look it up.
I know.
In the number of years I've been associated. Oh, wait, here's. Nope, that's not Rachel Dumlau. I think she just came out to get the bat. That now batting is Rachel Ogasawara. My apologies. She takes inside. Two down for the Buff and Blue. Top of the second, runner on second. Swing and a miss, big swing and a miss. Nice pitch by JC Young.
Yeah, that off speed is really working well for her today. She seems to be on it. Really gonna throw the Kamehameha batters off all day today with that.
Gasawara looked like she really just screwed herself into the ground on that one. A grounder pulled down the third base line.
Hits the cameraman along the way.
He's kind of semi-hiding behind the post there. just praying that it doesn't hit his camera. I'm certain he's not the only one.
JC Young has two strikes on this batter, so we don't want any down the middle. Nothing that she can easily hit.
A swing and a miss for Ogasawara. Nice pitch by JC Young.
Yep, absolutely. That riser is obviously going to be her go-to pitch to make those batters chase. Well executed by her.
So after 1.5 innings, we're all even. 0-0. Coming up to bat, leading off the top of the second for the Buff and Blue will be JC Young, pitcher and hitting cleanup. It's no joke that your pitcher is usually your best athlete, huh?
I would beg to differ, but no.
Oh, okay. Or the shortstop, excuse me.
No. I'm just kidding. Yes, the pitcher, especially for JC Young, one of the leaders of this team, being a four-year senior, really just showing her athletic ability on both sides of the plate. You always want someone who's willing to take control offensively and defensively for your team, and JC Young's doing exactly that.
Yes, even during watching their warm-ups, you can just kind of figure that out. Even if you don't talk to coach beforehand, you can just watch the players on the field, and it's pretty easy to figure out who the team leaders are and who's a leader in training, let's say.
Absolutely, yeah.
Who's a leader in training.
The three captains for Punahou, we have JC Young, the pitcher, Vanessa Va'a, the first baseman, and Kylie Popovich, the catcher. And I believe Kylie and JC are both four-year varsity lettermen.
Yes.
I was going to say seniors again. Four-year varsity lettermen. And when we talked to Coach Bobby, he was saying that they're more lead by example. I mean, of course, they're vocal, they're on the field, but their work ethic, it comes strong. And it really is important to set that example, especially with the younger team.
All right, here we are, JC Young. leading off the bottom of the second for the Buffin Blue. And the pitch from Dung, she takes for ball one. Yes, our sight lines here are a little unusual. Here's where behind multiple nets and posts and. But we're just happy to be here.
Absolutely. Great weather, a nice cool breeze.
Blowing down the valley. Working with the Puna Vision crew. Great group of kids helping us out today on camera. Brock Santee, Byron Lee, Troy Inoka, junior, sophomore, respectively.
Yep. Great
working,
team.
Working for Yuri Biersock and his Puna Vision crew. Doing a ton of webcasts this year. This is quick math on this. This is my fourth or fifth webcast this spring.
This spring
since the beginning of March. And of course, that segues nicely into our Clash of the Titans volleyball tournament this Friday and Saturday. That all four games will be webcast. Fly ball to left field. Norton gets under it for out number one. A little bit of a snow cone action there.
No kidding. It looked like it was going to toilet bowl out of there, out of her glove. You know, the wind playing a little bit of a factor here. It looked like she was having a little bit of a hard time getting under that ball, maybe coming a little bit closer to the line on that one. But handle it well overall.
So it is blowing down the valley. It's going to pull towards the left field line. And batting now is Ari Hashimoto, the center fielder. She's a senior, one of Punahou's many multi-sport athletes.
She also plays Division II basketball,
D2 sector. Basketball. Swing and a miss.
Now, these girls are so talented at this age, you know, playing multiple sports, doing choir,
Vanessa
Va'a. Absolutely, you got to take into account these colleges must be looking after them pretty heavily.
Fouled that one off. Whereas Ari's going to the University of Oregon next fall. She's going to be a Duck.
Oh, quack, quack.
Quack. Nice campus, nice area.
You can see that Ari must be a pull hitter. The shortstop is playing over a lot.
Here you go, trying to slap the ball down to first baseman, shovels it to the second baseman covering. Nice cover by Kaya Naivi, the second baseman. As Hipa comes in to make the play. One down for the Buffin Blue, or two down, excuse me. Stepping to the plate, Amber Popovich, left fielder. The younger of the Popovai sisters, I should say.
It's amusing. And first two times around, and then we're good.
Right. She had a game-winning RBI in the bottom of the seventh against Mid-Pacific about a week or so ago when J.C. Young threw that no-hitter. She takes high. And great interview. Great interview. Usually Punahou kids aren't lacking for personality, and she was no exception. If you didn't see the interview, I won't repeat all of it, but go to youtube.com/Punavision. She's trying to slap that one, pops it, and Dung it bounces off of her glove, and she's going to be safe.
Absolutely.
You going to call that a hit?
I would call that an error.
Okay.
I mean, it looked a little bit like, you know, it touched her glove prior to hitting
right.
the ground. Can't give any discredit to Popovich running that thing out hard, never giving up on that.
Right. Well, I know in some schools of thought they are a little more lenient with pitchers fielding their position. I would agree. I would give an error, but I didn't know which school of thought you were coming from on that. And now we have the third baseman, Heaven Walk, a freshman starting at third base.
That's right. She came in a little bit into the season after an injury, I believe, to their starting third baseman, which was
Pua.
That's right, Pua. And you know, doing a stand-up job on this. It's no easy task coming in as a freshman and being thrown into the hot spot nonetheless. But
well, you played third base in college, didn't you?
I did for the University of Puget Sound, Division III.
Hey, but don't knock it. I'm a D3 athlete, too. Don't knock it.
But nonetheless, I mean, it is a different
it's a different mindset.
It's a different mindset, absolutely. A lot more reaction-based. So if she has the skills, then good on Punahou for putting her there, and she's done a very good job just stepping into that role and you know, fielding her position well. That's all that you can ask of her.
Well, I've heard several infielders who have played, you know, that have played around the infield when they go from like third to second. Grounder to short. They get it to first base for the third out of the inning for Heaven Wong. Once again, Buff and Blue get one on but can't get her around.
Yep, only two base runners so far for Punahou. That made it, and both made it to, oh, actually, no, sorry about that. Thielen Masada made it to second, and then Sumida was at first, correct?
I believe that.
Ari Hashimoto, no?
Popovich. Popovich.
Wow. My apologies.
Yeah, we don't have a statistician here. We're keeping our own stats. No sports information department. Hey, we're a high school, and we're doing TV here. We're doing TV.
But solid volunteer basis over
solid
here.
Solid volunteer basis. That's right. But we're getting ready to go to the top of the third. And have one hit so far been through two innings for both teams.
Absolutely.
And like we said, whoa, heads up. Hot shot here. Maybe we should put the net. The left fielder launching one into foul territory during warm-ups. But imagine a number of these players will go on and do and play at the next level, even if it isn't Division I. You know, there's something to be said for going to school, you know, even if it's D2 or D3, and playing. I mean, it's, you know, it's a camaraderie thing, and you get to extend your playing career for another couple years.
Absolutely. I was speaking with JC Young's mother just a few minutes ago, and she was talking about how JC wants to go ahead and play in the next level. I mean, it's such a great entryway into college to have a group of friends that you already know. Playing a sport does offer so much more at the next level, but I mean, if they want to do it, go ahead. I don't think there's anyone that's stopping them. There's a lot of girls with talent on this team, on both teams, and I, of course, we don't know the Kamehameha team very well, but I'm sure there's a lot of girls going on to play at the next level.
A lot of athletes. And then he pops that one up. Evan Wong's going to get under that for out number one, top of the third. We're back to the top of the order for the Warriors. Leah Zablon stepping to the plate. She grounded a short her first time out.
Hey, we'll see what she can do on this one. Maybe pop it through one of the holes. Well, I guess for Pernell's sake, we don't want her to do that, but offensively, it's really important for her as not only the first batter, but, you know, there is one out. For her to get on is key right now.
Well, especially in softball, where it's so important, where there's, you see a lot more manufacturing of runs, getting that leadoff runner on and getting them the second is so much more important.
Absolutely. The key of the, I mean,
great pitch from JC Young there. She just screwed Zablon into the ground on that one.
Yeah, it actually, after she swung, it did hit her in the foot. I think for a little bit, Zablon thought that she was going to get on base, but when you swing and it hits you, it's still considered a strike.
Even if it's only going 40 miles an hour by the time it hits you.
Exactly.
We're trying another off-speed pitch there. It's a ball.
JC continuing to mix it up here, keeping the batters off balance. Going in, going out.
That takes just high and outside to Zablon.
JC really using that changeup a lot today. And as we could see earlier, it's working for her. So if, as long as it keeps on working against the batter.
And she goes down swinging.
Yep, that one.
Second out of the third inning.
Yep, that one was a high outside pitch. Just to kind of make her chase. Really great technical pitching right now for JC Young, hitting her spots.
Four strikeouts for JC Young through two and a third.
Wow.
Now batting Caitlin Mahalona, the right fielder. She strike number one.
Yep, the left.
JC Young seems like she's feeling it today.
I think so. I think she really is stepping up to the plate. Getting herself in the zone. We could see even earlier in her pregame
warm-up. Grounder to first. Va'a gets there. There you see the second baseman for Punahou. Sumida not able to hang on to the throw from Va'a. What would you give that? What do you call that? Should you give her a hit?
I would consider that, again, to be an error. It was a fieldable ball. The throw was gettable, unfortunately, and it just seemed like, you know, second baseman Hashimoto couldn't hold on to it. It is always a tough play down the line, but, you know, we got to make those.
There you see the runner stealing second. Caitlin Mahalona in safely to second base.
That one just a little too close for comfort. Great throw by Popovich, though. As you can see in softball, which is similar, different from baseball sometimes, the shortstop usually always covers the second base. And the reason for that is just the vision factor. They can see the ball. Second baseman and shortstop don't play as deep as they do in, say, baseball.
There you see a base hit from Hipa. And Mahalona is rounding the bases. She's going to score the first run of the game for Kamehameha. Caitlin Mahalona putting the Warriors up 1-0 in the top of the first. Nice base hit.
Absolutely.
From number 30, the first baseman, Christine Hipa.
Straight up the middle. Runner on second base had a great jump. So there is no chance of getting her out at home. And a good solid throw to the cutoff man. That's the best he can do on a play like that.
Nice piece of hitting, stepping to the plate for Kamehameha. Atisha Norton, the left fielder. She struck out her first time up. Swing and a miss. So in a game like this, every run, crucial.
Oh yes, every run. In these games, especially between Punahou and Kamehameha, when the tension is high, you can't ask for, you know, you can't have any errors. You really have to play your A game in every single pitch.
And Punahou's had two errors so far. You can't afford to do that, as you see that one's fouled back. Mm-hmm.
You know, that allowed the runner to get onto first, and ultimately she scored.
She took second on the stolen base and scored on the base hit. By Hipa. That's a foul down the first baseline. There you see ROTC getting their practice in on the center field courts. Oh, got a nice little crowd here. There's a few hundred people here probably.
Possibly. I mean, spread all around Rice Field. So from the big banyan tree over there to.
Yep. Number of Punahou parents down the third base line. That's a swing and a miss. Two strikes. Now on Atisha Norton, a junior left fielder for Kamehameha. There's another strikeout, and that will be out number three, but not before Kamehameha notches their first run. Notches the first run of the game to put themselves up 1-0.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. We being Punahou, really have to come back strong at this inning. We can't let them, you know, go a few more innings without a scoreless inning here. See what we can do.
Hold them to one run. Can't have any more errors.
Mm-hmm.
That would be.
And I'm sure that's exactly what Kamehameha is thinking right now as well.
Only one base hit for the Buff and Blues so far, with Daylen Masada led off with a dribbler single. She beat down, legged out down the first baseline. And there you see Kamehameha's Caitlin Mahalona. There's a little bit of the crowd down the first baseline.
You know, so far, Zaina Dung, the pitcher for Kamehameha, has been really doing a great job of keeping the Punahou batters in check.
Mm-hmm.
You know, hasn't mm-hmm. given a lot of opportunity for them to be making solid base hits. Even on the bunt attempts, you know, just really throwing inside, jamming them on their hands. We'll see what Thielen Masada is able to do on this one.
This is Sumita leading off the bottom of the third.
Two lefties in a row then.
Yeah. Second baseman. See if she can possibly atone. And hopefully she's not focusing on Well driven past the left fielder. That's going to roll to the fence. That's going for extra bases. Is she going to stand up at second? Yes, she is. Sarah Sumita. Stand up double. Well done, Sarah Sumita, the 5'2" sophomore.
Right into left center, just cranking that.
Laced it.
Absolutely. It was such a great hit. Solid hit. Kamehameha calling a timeout to get their thoughts together. This is exactly where Punahou wants to be.
Exactly what they needed. Mm-hmm. Start off with a base hit, get a runner into scoring position. Absolutely. Kamehameha took the lead in the top of the third. Mm-hmm. Now Punahou threatening with no outs in the bottom half of the inning.
And here they have Thalen Masada coming up, another great slapper. And especially with speed on second, with Sumita on second. They have a really great chance at scoring, if not at least advancing the runner here.
Now stepping to the plate is the right fielder, number 2, Jenna Shinsato, 5'2", senior. Oh, wait. How did that happen?
Shinsato's actually the...
My apologies. That's what happens when you write this down and don't keep track. Right, back to the top of the order. Glad one of us is keeping attention, Kelly. Thank you for coming.
Well, we're keeping each other in check with limited resources that we do have.
That's okay. I was a 5-year senior.
Thalen Masada showed bunt on that one, trying to draw the defense in, and it's very, very crucial for her to keep her the defense in check on this. Like we said, the left-handed batters have a lot that they can work with, so hopefully she can pop it through one of these holes or, if anything, lay down a solid bunt to advance the runner.
There's a lace sharply back to the pitcher, and they get double her up at second. Sarah Sumita caught off base. Well done by the pitcher, Dung. Wow.
What a very nice double play. That's the best feeling you can have for a pitcher. The batter just laces them right back at you, and you turn the double. That's as sweet as it gets.
Now they have 2 out and nobody on. The Buff and Blue were threatening.
This is a huge at-bat for Punahou. There's a slight momentum switch on that last play, so.
She takes for a strike.
And this is Kylie Popovich. See what we can do here with Sho's butt and the slap.
Fouling it off. Yeah, tough luck for the Buff and Blue there.
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
But that was a great defensive play by Kama Dung, showing her athleticism. Is the sophomore swing and a miss of Kylie Popovich. She goes down swinging. Punahou started the top half of the part of that inning good and then goes down meekly.
I think a little bit of it was for Sumita on second was her adrenaline. Maybe getting really excited, thought that one was going to go through. And really, in times like these, it takes a little bit of got to play smart in those situations. If it laces up the middle, it's still considered a line drive. It's still an out, and you still have to run appropriately.
Wanting to get around the bases a little too hard, being a little too eager. I mean, you like to see some enthusiasm. You like to see, being heady. But that ball was hit so sharply, and Dung made such a quick play to turn that around.
Absolutely.
And get Sumita at second.
Yeah. Well, this is their time to get it back, on defense. Just keep her head in the game and
don't get down.
Exactly.
Don't get down.
And it looks as if right now, she's not. I think that they have enough composure right now to get back in the game. There's still a lot of innings left here, a lot of at-bats to make it up, and a lot of plays to be made.
We're through 3 complete. Kamehameha up by a score of 1-0. Here on Middle Field at Punahou School, I am Mike Machado, joined by Kelly Ishii, former Buff and Blue softballer.
Yep, nice to be back.
Nice to be back. Do you get back on campus a lot?
I don't, actually. I think the last time was, first time in a long time was for Punahou Carnival, which I believe is an annual reunion for myself.
Right. Pop-up food trucks.
Absolutely.
Get the food. It's all about the food. It's all about the food.
Yep. It used to be all about the games, and then it used to be all about the rides.
See, grounder foul down the third baseline. There you
Nice hustle by the shortstop.
Getting that back in. They have two nets up today, one guarding us and one guarding the bleachers on the left field line. Don't want the parents to get hurt. See Kaya Naivi at the plate for the Warriors. She pops that one foul. Is that going to hit our truck? No. That isn't. Safely fielded by an on-guard parent. There you go.
Fans come in all ages today.
Just the young dribbles that one home. Yeah, well, everyone comes back for Carnival, right?
I would assume so. I think if you're in the islands, it's a little bit easier, obviously. I do have still a few friends that come in from the mainland to, you know, still support and even volunteer at the Carnival. I mean, the community here is just something special, something completely different than a lot of high schools.
Well, there's a reason both of us are sitting here giving our time.
Exactly. I mean, on volunteer basis, like we say, right?
That's right. That's right.
For the love of the game.
That's right. Another dribbler down the third baseline. Getting around early on a lot of those is Kaya Naivi, second baseman.
Yep, and that has a lot to do with J.C. Young's pitching right now. You know, going inside on some pitches and even throwing a little off speed throughout this series, the sequence.
For
the
most part, doing a good job of keeping the Warrior batters off balance. And there's CC getting around way early again is Naivi. Two strikes.
You know, in series like this, you just say whoever is going to break first ultimately is who's going to win this game, and they're battling every single at-bat, every single play. It seems like a battle.
Mm-hmm. And there you see J.C. Young giving up the walk to Naivi in a very tough at-bat. Young throwing a lot of pitches to Naivi. Now stepping to the plate, the pitcher, Kama Dung. She was hit by J.C. Young last time up. Nobody out, top of the fourth. Kamehameha at the plate. One runner on. No. Of course, Kama Young made that a great stab of a line drive coming at her. She throws down the bunt. Wong gets it down to second base, advancing the runner. And then on the throw, it sails past the center fielder covering. And Naivi's going to come all the way around. That's going to be a two-base error. She's going to take second on the sacrifice. And she's going to come all the way around to score.
Yep.
Second baseman probably would have been better. Sumita would have been better served to just eat that ball instead of trying to make the ambitious play and get Naivi at second.
Absolutely. If you're going to make that play at second base, you need to be absolutely sure that that ball is going to be right on the money.
Yeah, yeah, and she's not having her best day. Probably tell you, not having her best day in the field right now.
Yep.
I mean, you like players to be heady like that, but when it doesn't work.
Right. I mean, you can't knock her for being aggressive. You can't knock her for wanting to make the play.
Correct.
Absolutely, but it's just a little bit, you know, like, mix up with the adrenaline. We said we keep on repeating about how big of a game this is. We need to smart up a little bit.
There you see Ho'uhuli popping to left field. Amber Popovich gets under that for out number two.
Amber Popovich on that last one, though, you know, in a decent position to be there, but I think a little bit caught off guard at the fact that she was going to have to cover for that ball. So doing the best that she could out there.
Seen stepping to the plate for the Warriors, the catcher, Ogasawara, a sophomore. She fouls that one back. As I said before, very balanced Kamehameha team, top to bottom, three freshmen, four sophomores, three juniors, four seniors on this Kamehameha team.
I mean, you can't ask for anything more than that as a head coach on your team to be so level, but, you know, it seems like they have a good sense of leadership on their team. Athletic ability is definitely there. You know, it's just seeing how they execute throughout the game and if they can carry that on all seven innings.
So the Warriors are up by a score of 2-0 now. And of course, on that, in that, you know, earlier this inning, of just that very heady play by Naivi, running all, you know, getting all the way around from first base on what was just ostensibly going to be a sacrifice. And there's a pop to Va'a at first base, and that's the end of the fourth inning, but not before the Warriors get a run on no hits.
Absolutely. It's a huge error, but nonetheless, something that they can come back from. You know, it's only 2-0, I believe.
Yes, yes, it is.
So, I mean, that can easily be taken care of in one inning. It's just going to be a battle for Punahou to really execute well in these next couple at-bats, get someone on, and move them along.
2-0 is not an insurmountable lead, but Buff and Blue cannot afford to throw the ball around the infield as they have, and they got to hang on to it, mm-hmm. too. We've seen a number of instances where I'm certain they would have wanted that play back.
Absolutely. But that's the game of softball or baseball, is you're always going to want every mistake you made back, because it's instrumental. That's why they say anything can happen in this game, is because, you know, defensively and offensively.
Well, the best teams in any sport do the fundamentals very, very well.
Absolutely. But no one's perfect, and, you know, it's impossible to have a perfect season, unlike some sports like football. But I think at this level, yes, fundamentals are key for, especially in softball. The mental game beyond is something that's going to take a team from being great or good to great, or just from being athletic to really being something phenomenal.
Well, years ago, when I was traveling with the UH team, they were playing UCLA in the NCAA regionals, and the one thing that struck me during warmups was just how obscenely fundamentally sound that UCLA team was. And leading off the top of the fourth for the Buff and Blue, Nicole Nishizawa. But during warmups, the one thing that just struck me was just how insanely precise just their warm caught everything. Every throw was perfect. And they won the national title that year. Go figure.
Absolutely. I think when you look at a team in their warmup, you know, it's kind of like that Michael Jordan saying where, like, you know, it's really how you play when no one's watching, right?
Yes.
Practice,
yes.
No one's watching. So, you know, a lackadaisical throw here and there might eventually be how you play in the game.
And you know, practice sharp, play sharp.
Absolutely.
Nishizawa at the plate, designated player for the Buff and Blue, struck out her first time up in the top of the first. She takes a strike there, I believe.
Yep. Hopefully she can get something started right here.
Buff and Blue definitely in need of a base hit of anything at this point, as she fouls that one off. She's got two strikes on her. Does Nishizawa. 5'7" sophomore fouls that one back. Straight up over our tower. We have one of the big kids, Andrew Ryan, high up there in the lift, shooting down on our home plate camera. See one of our big kids.
Great.
There's a Nishizawa grounder to short. Not able to beat that out, as the shortstop Misty Ho'ohuli does a great job of snagging that one and getting it over to first.
That was just a great battle, though, by Nishizawa, staying in the game, making sure that the pitcher, Zaina Dung, was, you know, getting her reps in there. They're not giving anything away too quickly. You know, it could pay off for the next batter, Vanessa Va'a.
And she's somebody that could get a run back for us in a hurry. She makes contact. There you see her swinging for the fence. I believe she has Punahou's only home runs this year.
Really?
With two, does Vanessa Va'a. She takes for a ball 1-1 to Va'a. Can hear the breeze blowing through our mics, all three of us.
Va'a calls time there, gathers his thoughts in a little bit in order.
How much of that is trying to throw the pitcher off their rhythm, or is it, there's a Va'a hit sharply to Ho'ohuli. She doesn't get down for it. E6 on that. I'm not asking the softball player on that one. I'm calling that an E6. Ho'ohuli's, you know, slapping at herself. You know, she can't afford to do that. Mm-hmm. It's only a two-run game, but that was a fieldable ball, a sharply hit, but playable.
Absolutely. I think we've been talking, you know, Punahou not being able to afford to make those errors, but same thing with Kamehameha. They can't afford to make those errors either. It's crucial in this game. It's anyone's game right now. It's still early. You know, they're putting speed on first now with their designated runner here.
Yes. 13, Astra Kidani. She's got all kinds of speed. She was a point guard on Punahou's Varsity 1 basketball team this year. Going to see a lot more of her in the years to come. Very speedy is the freshman. Now stepping to the plate is the pitcher for the Buff and Blue, J.C. Young. Flied to left field her first time up. Fouls off that pitch.
Looks like she was showing bunt on that one, hoping to advance the runner. If she does, hopefully, she needs to know that she needs to lay that down, but she's doing a great job offensively and defensively so far, so hopefully she can help her own cause.
There she is, showing bunt again and pulling back. Now wishing I had worn jeans and a hoodie today. It's breezy.
It's getting a little cold here.
Of course, it's been a little chilly the last few days all over the state. J.C. Young fly to short center field. Center fielder gets there. Rachel Dumlau coming in nicely for the Warriors. Get that first out.
Yeah, that one looked like it went a little bit off the inside of her bat, but still just a very nice swing on J.C. Young's part. Just hoping that next time it'll meet up a little bit better.
See Ari Hashimoto. Flashing bunt. She pops it to second base. Naivi is there for the third out of the inning. And there you go. And the Buff and Blue go meekly in the bottom of the fourth.
You know, Punahou still does have some time here, but, you know, I'm sure the coaches are realizing that it does need to pick up a little bit. They need to, you know, bring it together in a sense. They need to play smart, make sure that there's no errors coming up here and doing everything that they can defensively to hold Kamehameha to no runs anymore. And, of course, picking up their offensive game.
Well, of course, Kamehameha leads the league in runs scored and runs allowed, actually. Yes, they've scored 77 runs on the year, and they've only allowed 12, whereas the Buff and Blue have scored 53 and have allowed 15 or 16, I believe. Sadly, I can't read my writing on that. I only write like a doctor.
But, you know, that's great news for Punahou then. They can take advantage of that. You know, who knows? They could quite possibly, you know, make a run for it right now.
Right, but they don't want to let any more runs across because Kamehameha is not going to give up a ton.
Absolutely.
They're not going to give up a ton. Here, but wonderful day for a webcast. I mean, I'd shudder to think what was going on if it was raining out here.
Oh.
I mean, a lot of this stuff.
I might have left you, actually.
Oh.
A little bit of a prima donna attitude right there.
Are you? All right. Most of the webcasts we do are, of course, indoors. And here we see popped up down the third base line. Heaven Wong is trying to get under it. Thalen Masada may have had a better angle on that. But Heaven Wong not real happy with herself on that. It was playable, but foul.
Absolutely. That's great of J.C. Young just picking up her shortstop there. You know, it was, like you said, playable, but, you know, things happen. It wasn't exactly the easiest of plays, and J.C. Young showing her support for her teammate there. The Kamehameha bench is a little bit louder now, but doesn't look like it's phasing Punahou at all.
Don't hear the cheering as much. Grounder sharply to the third baseman, Wong. She gets to Va'a at first. Nicely done by Va'a. Get down the throw, and good of Wong to not get rattled when she kind of fumbled it a little bit. She stayed with it and got it to first.
Absolutely. Making up that, you know, there's this little debacle here on the foul line, but no harm, no foul on that one.
No harm after the foul.
Oh, boy.
Yes, I'm full of them. Ooh, sharply hit up towards our cameraman. The plate for Kamehameha. Number 8, Malia Zablon. grounded to short and struck out her first two times up.
Mm-hmm. Juicy Young showing her heat on that one, going right at the batter.
She takes high. How hard is she throwing? You think?
Well, let me pull out my radar gun and try it.
Well, you seem like the accessorizing type. I didn't know. Fouls that one back. Self-proclaimed prima donna. You know, who knows if you're carrying a jugs gun in your bag.
Oh, no. You know, it's hard for me to tell. I'll be very honest. A lot of the time, I don't have a good eye as to how fast things are going.
Well, if you had to guess, how fast?
Probably by speed. I'm just not going to.
Guess what do you tell the police officer?
Yeah. Here we go.
Popped down the third baseline. Thalen Masada,
yes.
Great job of tracking as Thalen Masada chasing that down.
And Nisar's stay inside that second line, that demarcation line. It's usually when there's a player on that they can't advance past that line, but if it is a playable ball, a foul ball with no runners on, then she can go ahead and pass that line.
And now batting for the Warriors, number 5, Caitlin Mahalona, the right fielder, flied to short and reached on an error by the second baseman.
Yep. Scored one run earlier.
Grounded shortstop. Oh! Masada, another great job of getting there, and she gets it to on first. Thalen Masada showing off.
What a play there, just showing her range. She actually was playing a little deep towards the third baseman and made a nice stab at that ball, and just a perfectly accurate throw there.
And of course, talking to Coach Bobby before the game, she's a converted center fielder. This is her. She's not like one of those lifetime shortstops where, oh, I'm the best athlete here. I'm going to play shortstop. I'll do it all. But you see her showing her range there a number of times.
Yep. I mean, it does help root some her speed, most likely. On top of that, though, it's a different way of looking at the ball. It's a different, it's a different mindset. So for her to make that conversion is just something special. And this is only your second year in varsity as well. So to go from center field to shortstop in 2 years is just unbelievable. Shows her athletic ability very much. You know, and sometimes defense can pick up the offense. And plays like that are just catalysts for, you know, big plays, big offensive plays as well. You know, it brings the team together a lot. So we'll see what Puno can do here. I'm sure no one more than them wants to pick something up right now.
Do players draw a lot of energy when they see great defensive plays like that as much as they may from, a well-stroked ball?
Oh, absolutely. That's why there's two sides to the game. It's how the athlete, a great play is a great play regardless on what side it is.
Certainly a lot of high fives going around the Punahou bench after those two defensive efforts from Thalen Masada.
Oh, yeah. That was her inning right there, her defensive inning.
And here you see Amber Popovich leading off the bottom of the fifth for the Buff and Blue. Dung bounces that one low, ball one.
Pitch selection is really, really crucial right now for the Buff and Blue. Want to make sure that they're not, giving away anything to the pitcher here.
He takes for a strike, 1-1 to the left fielder. See, Dung with the pitch, fouled off. Pop, it looks like she wanted to pull back on that one and couldn't quite get it back in time.
Yep, just the check swings are the worst. You know, you start to commit and you realize halfway through that's probably not the pitch that you want to get at, but that's what that pitch is made for. Ultimately by the pitcher. Caught her on an off-speed pitch on that one.
One down for the Buff and Blue in the bottom of the fifth. Stepping the plate for Punahou, the third baseman, Heaven Wong, a freshman. One of two freshmen, along with Astra Kidani. Both of them also varsity basketball players.
Just purely to their athletic ability there.
That's right.
You know, Heaven we can't speak enough about because, you know, just stepping into that role as a freshman is, you know, something that's not usually expected, but she took on the task very, very well.
That's what the team needed, right?
Absolutely.
How many third basemen will wear mouth guards?
When I played in school, I didn't wear a mouth guard, but looking back, that probably wasn't the smartest idea. You know, that ball does come back.
Sharply hit to third base by Heaven Wong, and she's on. Base hit for Heaven Wong.
Absolutely. What a line drive just straight down third base. Actually hit the third baseman in the foot, and it bounced off, which caused her to get a little frazzled and not be able to make that play.
I'm giving her the hit even though she made
contact. Oh, absolutely.
That was sharply hit.
That was not definitely an error. There's no debate there.
You see Sarah Sumita, who doubled her last time up in the top of the third.
See what they're able to generate here. Nice bunt.
Able to advance Wong. And Sumita is safe at first.
Looks
I think
like
Kamehameha is going to rightly call a conference with two on.
Looks like there's a little bit of discussion between the umpires here to see how that play really ended. I'll be very honest, I didn't see the play at first. I was watching the runner from second, thinking that she was going to take third because the third baseman wasn't covering her base very well, and there was an opportunity with Heaven Wong's speed to go ahead and take advantage of that.
And so now as the Buff and Blue step back to their top of the the top of the order, they're calling her safe at first. Of course, now Buff and Black, as I was saying, to the top of the order with two on. The bottom of the fifth. Time for some timely hitting from Thaylen Masada.
Yep. I'm sure they want to give the crowd a little something to cheer for, give them a little bit of excitement here.
Of course, she singled to lead off the bottom of the first, and then lined back to the pitcher her last time up, the top of the third.
Yep, this is it right here for Thaylen Masada. This is where she wants to step up and, you know, like you said, like we were talking about.
Show that senior leadership.
Exactly, but that defensive, you know, inning may generate something special for her here. But, you know, pitch selection is huge. You know, what the coaches decide that they want to do here, they want to lay down the bunt and move the runners over. If they want to just let her hit away, it's really.
Well, what would you do? Your number one hitter is up. You know, one of the better, you know, I believe she's leading the team in average.
It's difficult to say, you know, it looks like there's a little bit more speed on third than there, on third baseman than there's on the first baseman. But
there she is, he lays down the bunt down the first base line.
Oh, there it is.
Cut throw down the first base line. Wong's going to round third, she's going to score. And there you see Sumita's going to score. And Masada all the way around to third, and she is safe. A two-run bunt single. All even
I
here
get a little
now.
Excited there.
But you're allowed to get excited.
You know, it's just those great plays. Thaylen Masada making a perfect bunt down to the right side and really making them make the play. And they couldn't execute and
put pressure on the defense.
Exactly. There's anything can happen in this sport, and that's exactly what Punahou needed was a, you know, just a little bit of luck there. And great base running on all counts. We saw some excellent base running
from Wong and Sumita.
Absolutely. Sumita coming around and, you know, stopping halfway through, saw that the throw was beating her, but unfortunately the catcher couldn't make the play and was able to follow through and score.
So that was probably two errors on that.
Yeah, we had a throwing error coming home and
one on the throw to first, then one on the throw home.
Absolutely.
With two runs and Kylie Popovich at the plate. She's laying down the bunt to score. Masada on the squeeze. They're trying to draw the throw. Punahou doing a great job of playing some small ball here as they score three runs now in the bottom of the fifth to take a 3-2 lead over the Warriors in the bottom of the fifth.
Just really great softball here. Textbook, you know, laying it down when you need to, and a perfectly called suicide squeeze by Punahou coaching there. Taking advantage of their momentum, taking advantage of, you know, maybe Kamehameha not so on top of it right now.
Well, put pressure on the defense. Mm-hmm. Put pressure on the defense. There you see a pinch runner going in for Popovich. You see who that is.
You know, that's all that you can ask from your second.
Paige Kawhi, pinch runner at first base, going in for Popovich.
You know, Kylie Popovich, as a second batter, is usually going to see a lot of sacrifice bunt opportunities, and you know, it just show itself, and she was able to get on while she was at it.
It's a grounder to short, They get it to first for the second. They called her safe. First baseman's foot came off the bag. Tough inning for the Warriors. Safe all around, two on.
Yep, you can start
with
seeing
one out.
You can start seeing a little bit more emotion coming out of the usually calm and collective Kamehameha players, but Punahou on their home field really showing what they can do.
Yes, they are. Buff and Blue threatening again with two on in the bottom of the fifth. They already have three runs across. And Vanessa Vaugh stepping to the plate with two on. Buff and Blue threatening to blow this game open.
Well, let's not talk too soon here now, but ultimately they do want someone with the power of Vaugh to come up and, you know, bust this game open. But, you know, let's not speak too soon. We want it to actually happen, so. But Vaugh hasn't been necessarily able to connect against Dung today, so, you know, hopefully she's able with the past two at-bats to gain a better sense of what's going on here.
Vanessa Vaugh struck out her first time out, reached on an error, shortstop error, her second time up. Really hoping to make contact here. Be a great time to go shopping at the Gap, I say. Stick around, I'm full of
yeah, it. Yeah, no kidding. You can see that the Kamehameha outfielder is actually playing her way back, trying to keep that ball in front of them so they can make the play at home. Damage to a minimum.
Dung bounces that one. Don't want to give Vanessa Vaugh anything real juicy to hit.
You know, and props to the catcher back there. That pitch was in the ground and she kept that in front of her, otherwise holding the runners from stealing.
Ooh, her eyes got big on that one. Might have wanted to sit on that.
Mm-hmm. You can see everyone on the Punahou bench, even the parents over here, rallying behind Vaugh, hoping that she's gonna at least get that bat on the ball.
She takes for a ball.
Everyone's on the edge of their seats here, seeing what's gonna happen.
Including us. Including us. Vaugh fouls that one off. Two strikes on V.
You know, her timing is impeccable on that pitch. She went straight back behind the catcher. Right as a line drive, so just a little bit under the ball, but she can at least hit it pretty solid. That ball's gonna fly.
I think we have some of our intermediates out there ready to catch one. Should she go long? Foul down. Hi, wave everybody. There we go. Right between our two nettings here.
Yep, it's a good setup we got going.
Well, in previous installments of Punahou softball, we only had the net facing the field, and then there's Vanessa, sliced it to center field. That's going to roll to the fence, and that's going to score two runs. Oh, no, that Nishizawa held up at third base. That's going to score Kawhi.
I think that's what everyone was waiting for in this, I wanted to say stadium, but at this field, you know, just for Vanessa Vaugh to make some noise, I've been hearing she did that well with a gapper to right center. So right now we have Vaugh on first and Nishizawa on third, and this is the ideal offensive play. Every coach not necessarily dreams of this, but I would say would love to take advantage of the first and third situation.
Why does the Buff and Blue have scored four runs here? The bottom of the fourth, just one down, runners at the corners. Mm-hmm. As I said, Buff and Blue threatening to blow this one open.
Absolutely.
The bottom of the fifth.
And we'll see what the coaching staff has kind of drummed up here. See if they, you know, they let the batter hit away, or if they, you know, manufacture something, maybe a little bunt and run. We do have Vanessa Vaugh on second here, and basically no pinch runners left, so.
First.
Oh, first, sorry.
Cole Nishizawa at third, Vanessa Vaugh at first. J.C. Young at the plate, flied out both times up to left and center.
You know that J.C. Young definitely wants to connect here and help her own self out.
Help her own cause. foul tip.
Hot on that off-speed pitch there.
Buff and Blue in third place right now in the ILH behind Kamehameha and Maryknoll. Punahou manages to keep this together and score the victory. It'll make the ILH look very, very interesting.
How many state bursts are there from the ILH?
I believe there are two. Great. But it would definitely put some heat on Kamehameha because they're two losses up on Maryknoll. And Buff and Blue, there is a fly ball to right field. There you see Caitlin Mahelona getting to it. Nice job of tracking that down, but it scores Nishizawa from third.
Yeah, great defensive play on that right fielder's part. Really making a great catch and getting that ball in as soon as possible, getting Va'a back to first. But nonetheless, the damage is being done slowly, hit by hit.
Five runs now for the Buff and Blue here in the bottom of the fifth, up by a score of 5-2. Mildly curious to see if the Warriors are going to change up pitchers here or they're going to stick with Kama Dung.
I think the Kamehameha coaching staff has a solid trust in what Dung can do. See if she can get herself out of this one.
Two down now in the bottom of the fifth. Hashimoto, the ninth hitter in this inning. Am I keeping track here right? Yes, she is the ninth hitter in this inning. Buff and Blue batting around, fouls one back here in the bottom of the fifth. I think we should put in a requisition for a space heater.
I was going to say, I'm over here rubbing my hands together and
pops that one foul. Of course, last time we were here, I was mocking Nancy for wearing a hoodie, and now here I am.
I know, wishing.
Yeah.
Actually, I think I have a little bit more of another jacket here.
Well, it's not going to fit me.
Selfish, I know.
Yeah, you're not the only prima donna. Another foul ball from Hashimoto.
A little ahead on that one. Just trying to get that bat on the ball. Make something still, there's a lot of magic left on Punahou's side, so if they can string a few more together, it'd be nice insurance there.
Moto strikes out to end the fifth inning, but not before the Buff and Blue put five on the board, and they bat around to the bottom of the fifth. 5-2 going to the top of the sixth, Punahou over Kamehameha.
Yeah, Kamehameha really needs to collect their thoughts and get on the same page here. Basically what they're wanting is another inning, just like how Punahou had, and bounce back from that. It's going to take a lot of mental toughness on their part to get to that level, but don't put it past them. They're a solid team, and
they're ranked number one in the state currently.
Wow, exactly. Unfortunately for them, they're not used to being behind in the score, but we'll see how they're able to handle that, if they're worthy of that number one position.
I'm pretty certain this is the most runs they've given up all year.
Well, hopefully, next time Punahou comes around, they can tack on a few more.
A few more. Only 12 runs allowed this year for the Warriors. Buff and Blue hanging five on them through five so far. But, now would be a good time to get some in. I started speaking about the Clash of the Titans volleyball this weekend. Friday and Saturday, Punahou's annual Clash of the Titans boys volleyball tournament. Punahou, Kamehameha Hawaii, Santa Barbara, and the Punahou of California volleyball. They might say the other way, but MiraCosta, the volleyball school in California. They're the professed volleyball factory of Southern California. Excellent, excellent program, excellent players coming into play this week, and all the games will be webcast on Punavision, so be sure to log in again, punahou.edu/webcasts, or you can catch them archived at youtube.com/punavision. Usually catch those a couple days later. Me and T-Mac, Tony McInerney, calling the first day of games as we're up top of the sixth inning now. Christine Hippa, the first baseman, leading off the top of the sixth for the Warriors. And then second night, we'll have Coach Peter Balding. Sharply hit down the left field line, and they're going to call that. That's going to be a ground rule double.
She really laced that one.
Laced that one.
Right past Heaven Wong. I don't think she was expecting that.
At all. Not a chance. And that rolls down the line and out of play. Stand-up double for the first baseman.
You know, it's really easy to get complacent here for Punahou. You know, you have a tight lead, but nonetheless, you can't let up. Kamehameha is coming after you, and they really need to focus in and play their A game still.
And we see Norton stepping to the plate for the Warriors. She walked and scored a run last time she was up in the top of the fourth. Kamehameha putting a pinch runner on. And sadly, her number is not on our roster. Uh-oh.
What?
Pinch runner, second base. Norton at the plate. She takes her strike. Of course, exactly what Kamehameha needed to answer a five-run fifth by the Buff and Blue. Get a runner in scoring position right away. Of course, the Warriors easily the most decorated of ILH softball teams. That's Kiana Burnett, the pinch runner at second. But yes, Kamehameha, they've won 8 state titles. Only Kailua has more. Kamehameha, let me take a breath. 85, 87, 91, 93, 94, 98, 02, and 08 have they won state titles. So they're not their program. Ooh, great pitch from J.C. Young, striking out Norton on that.
Punahou still looking for their first state title ever
in softball.
In softball. We're in high school, we came a little close to that, but fell short. I believe they only have 2 ILH titles as well, only one in 1974 and one in 2005.
One's a fouled back, Kaya Naivi at the plate. Excuse me, she walked and scored a run her last time up in the top of the fourth. It was Norton, who's now a 3-time strikeout victim of J.C. Young. One down, one on for the Warriors. Young bounces one.
Popovich.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Go ahead. You're straight behind the plate. You know, just really getting behind the ball and ensuring that the runner on second doesn't advance.
Keeping it in front of her.
Great, yeah.
Naivia, senior, struck out her first time up. It's another strike. 6 strikeouts on the afternoon for J.C. Young. Through 5 1/3. Nice ratio for J.C. Young. She laces that one sharply down the left field line. Parents playing it cool.
I don't know if I could say the same for myself, but.
We're behind a screen.
Yeah.
We both cowered. 1 year of baseball here. You know, you're not getting anything out of me. I couldn't hit it underhand. Young bounces another one. And they're taking third.
You know, those off-speed pitches can be really tough as a catcher to just keep in front of you and read off the hop, especially when they're coming so slowly like a changeup. But keeping in front is first and foremost, and Popovich did a great job in the bat, so.
One down, one on for the Warriors. That one's popped foul again. Kiana Burnett, the pinch runner at third.
Yep, this is a situation that Kamehameha really wants to start taking advantage of. They got a runner in scoring position. You know.
Fouled off of Naivi, holding the runner at third is the pitcher, J.C. Young. Let's Naivi go to first, reaching on a fielder's choice.
Actually, the umpire
hit her on
there.
The way, yeah.
The umpire did see the ball come off the batter's foot, called it foul. Great call by him. Unfortunately, the home base umpire didn't see it, so good heads up call by him.
I saw it. But my opinion doesn't count.
Nope.
On the field.
Heads up.
Go! Oh! Excuse me. Say channel Homer Simpson. See the edge of our tent there and the bleachers and the parents saying, look at the boy moving the ball.
Or not move.
Or not move. Yes. I don't move that fast unless I'm being chased.
By a bear.
Another foul ball into the netting. That's chased ED, not chased TE.
You can see it. Really, J.C. Young and the batter battling against one another. A lot of the same pitches coming out of her within the last couple of...
We saw this last time she was up, when she walked in the top of the fourth and came around to run. It was a real tough battle between her and J.C. Young, taking a lot of pitches, getting around early on a lot of pitches.
Yep, that one just missed. I know J.C. Young wanted that one. Whole Punahou defense wanted that one, but... just missed on the outside.
Punahou desperately wanting that second out. That's popped foul back behind the screen.
This is pure adrenaline right here for the batter and the pitcher. One against mano y mano. And we'll see who can battle this one out. Hopefully this time around it's J.C. Young.
Or Wahine on Wahine. Buff and blue on Warrior. The pitch, Kaivi, foul again, Heaven Wong, trying to get there, almost, just out of reach. So again, I haven't kept a tally of the number of foul balls I've gotten over here. I want to say four or five off the top of my head, but probably about six or seven foul balls.
Total, absolutely. You know, batter really has a great eye on this, so.
Sharply down the third base line, that's fair. Burnett's going to score. Nice piece of hitting by Kaya Naivi to score the pinch runner. Burnett, Kamehameha getting one back. 5-3 now in the top of the six. Buff and Blue still up. Of course, pitching coach for the Buff and Blue, Courtney Baufman, former Rainbow Wahine pitcher, going out to talk to J.C. Young. Calm her team down a little bit. Say, hey, all right, we gave one up. Still got one down. Let's get two.
Yep, absolutely. What's crucial is that they control the tempo from here on out.
Right.
They have the upper hand. You want to make sure that they're playing their game. They're at home. They don't want to fall into Kamehameha's, not so much trap, but just ultimately their rhythm and lose control here.
Nope, not at all. When you see home plate umpire calling, coming out and saying, all right, we've had enough. Candlesticks always make a nice gift. Need a whole chicken? Flex? Sorry. You're understanding my reference. This is good.
Yes.
This is good.
The tangent humor is, I'm a big fan of that, so.
Because I think Bull Durham came out when you were very young. Very young. I don't want to divulge a woman's age, but you were quite young when that movie came out.
J.C. Young here really wants to, you know, she seems focused. She seems like she has it in her. Just not throwing.
Pop fly to second base. Sumita getting under it. She gets it for out number two.
Crucial out coming up right here. Crucial batter, you know, with the runner on first. Even with a loop single, that's going to get them to third, so we want to make sure that they hold it here. A 5-3 ball game is much different than a 5-4. And
see,
as I say that.
Passed ball. Naivi takes second on that. Ho'uhuli at the plate, two down. Of course, now the Warriors have a runner in scoring position. Already managed to score one run here in the top of the six. Get a strike. Buff and Blue would like nothing more to escape this inning, only allowing one run. Foul ball sharply hit down the third base line.
Yep, it seems like they're almost picking on Heaven Wong over here in the hot corner.
Well, they're getting around early on J.C. Young's off-speed pitches.
Mm-hmm. And Heaven Young needs to be aware of that as well, you know. You know, picking up on those, on the tendencies of the Kamehameha catchers. You can see she moved down a little bit closer to the line, but she really needs to get a hold of that backhand if it comes at her.
So Young bounces one in.
The runner over at second, Kaya Naivi, being very aggressive off the base.
Of course, Ho'uhuli sacrificed her first time up, popped to left her second time up. Fouls another one off. Two strikes now on the shortstop, Misty Ho'uhuli. 5-3, top of the sixth on Punahou's middle field. We got an exciting one here.
It is.
This is a good game.
Oh,
that pop to left
blooper.
Field. Popovich going to get there. Yes, she does. Sliding grab by Amber Popovich. Well done. Well done.
Yep, just a crucial play. Perfect one to lay it all out for. You know, it was a super hardly hit, so you know that if it's going to fall down, that your center fielder is going to cover you. Just a very heads-up play by Amber Popovich.
Nicely, Buff and Blue happy to get out of that inning, only allowing one run.
Just a small scratch there.
Yes, yes, just a nick. Of course, the Buff and Blue still up by two. Well, the Warriors would like nothing better than to go 1-2-3 on the Buff and Blue here in the bottom of the sixth.
You can see that Zaina Dung is back on the mound. You know, probably got a little pep talk from her coaches on the sidelines, getting her back into the game, saying, telling her that, you know, She can come back from this.
There you see former Punahou softball coach and English teacher, Ed Moore. Appears to be a Red Sox fan as well, as many English professors are, English teachers are. Don't ask me why. But there he is. I see him on campus all the time. Played soccer with his son, Terry. A little bit of trivia there. Back in the day. We get ready to lead off the bottom of the sixth for the Buff and Blue. Amber Popovich, she of that sliding catch to end the top of the sixth. And there you see our athletic director, Jeannie Garcia, talking to president of the school, Dr. Jim Scott. Of course, Dr. Scott, a huge sports fan, huge. He's at everything. He's at everything. That's great to see if you're a student.
It really is. And even from when I was here, was always at our games supporting softball teams. So can't ask anything more from president, really.
Really.
Amber's 0-2 on this right now. She really needs to at least connect with the ball here.
We can hope. That one's last pitch dribbled in. Probably wishing she didn't swing at that, but that's what good pitching does.
Mm-hmm.
She takes that one, 1-2.
Yep. She definitely didn't want to go ahead and swing at that one, which was a little bit above waist high outside.
So Popovich reached on an error her first time up, struck out her last time up in the fourth. Swing and a miss. One down for the Buff and Blue.
Popovich,
top of the first.
Popovich,
top of the sixth, excuse me.
Yeah, no problem. No, Popovich actually took her eyes off the ball a little bit earlier than probably she should have. Kind of went with her head up and, you know, she's her head in there a little bit longer. Who knows how hard she'll connect.
Keeping your eyes on the ball ups your chances of hitting it exponentially, I'm told. Exponentially. I never played, but, you know, wise people have told me that. Stepping to the plate for the Buff and Blue, Heaven Wong. Third baseman, freshman, grounded to short her first time up, singled and scored in that big fifth inning for the Buff and Blue.
That off-speed pitch just missed. I know Zaina Dunn's been working with that, just as J.C. Young has, but we'll see how Heaven Wong takes advantage.
Popped down the third baseline, coming our direction, almost barehanded it. There I am. Hey, I almost got that on one grab. Hey, I'm talking and fielding at the same time. All right.
There you go, looking for a spur of offense.
They're foul down the third baseline. Right at our netting, and see there we're hiding. That's me waving again. from her perch in short left field. Heaven Wong battling at the plate.
Great eye on that one. Just not chasing after it. Came in and low on her, and she really did a great job of having good discipline and not swinging away at that.
She takes high for another ball.
These are the kind of at-bats you just kind of want to clear your head and let the body do the work, you know. Trust in your reaction skills. Really just focus in and...
Heaven Wong down the left field line. Pulled it. Foul. She got a lot of that one. Foul. Souvenir for the parents. There you see. Is that Scott Metcalf down there? He of all things Punahou. If there's something to get done at Punahou, Scott Metcalf's probably going to be there. Well, Heaven Wong fooled on that one. Second strikeout in a row for Dung. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven strikeouts for Kama Dung in this game. Batting Sumita at the plate. Two for two is Sarah Sumita in this game. Your nine hitter goes two for two. You're not, might not be your nine hitter for two much longer.
You know, I think it just rounds out the batting order a little bit. You know, you're going to have those days where you can, you know, just connect with the pitcher. And a lot of times, especially as a left-handed slapper, it's just a matter of it falling in the right places.
And she taps it meekly back to the pitcher. Three up, three down for the Buff and Blue. In the bottom of the sixth, going to the top of the seventh. The score, Punahou 5, Kamehameha Warriors 3.
It's a tight one here.
We got a good one here, Kelly.
Yep.
Got a good one.
This is it for Punahou. They really want to capitalize and make sure that their defense is solid on this. You know, you can't have the errors that they were making earlier in the game. They really need to focus in and realize this is it.
This is it. They're three outs away from beating the number one team in the state right now. And to make the ILH look very interesting, as I mentioned before, with a victory today, it would be Kamehameha's first loss. Mary Knowles in second place with two losses, and Kamehameha's and Punahou's right behind that with a 5-3 record. But the ILH is a very, very tough league. Mm-hmm. You know, three of those teams that I just mentioned are all in the top 10 in the state rankings right now. So Punahou's losses have all been very close so far, but it would definitely make things look very interesting.
Yep, they need this one to stay in that race. You know, they lost two unfortunate to, like you said, to Iolani and Marinol. So this is huge. This game is big for them to keep them in the race, ultimately.
That's right. The ILH getting two berths. Mid-Pacific not out of it just yet. They're 4-3 on the year, I believe. So they're not entirely out of it yet, and they are the two-time defending state champions.
Agreed.
So you can't count them out, but of course they lost Keiki Carlos to graduation and the University of Hawaii. And now leading off, top of the seventh, pinch hitter, Farron Glacken.
You know, this might, you know, Kamehameha's looking for a spark, and it could come in the form of Farron. I'm sure Punahou is feeling very confident right now. They really want this game. But it comes down to, you know, their mental game here. They're tired. It's cold.
Staying focused. You know, they gave up one early on. I think they were feeling good coming out of the bottom of the fifth, and then promptly in the top of the sixth, they gave up a double down the line, and as you alluded to, maybe they relaxed a little bit going into the top of the sixth. Mm-hmm. Oh, here we are, Glacken taking again here in the top of the seventh.
You know, JC Young is still really going towards that changeup and utilizing it a lot. It seems like the Kamehameha batters are sitting on it a little bit more than they were earlier in the game.
Ooh.
Called low on that. You can hear fans on both sides just yelling out their encouragement, and it's just so great to see here the amount of support that both teams have regardless of what team they're on.
It's an exciting game, and now we're in the top of the seventh, and that's down the first base line to Va'a. She snags it.
What a great play by Va'a.
Three unassisted. One down for the Warriors, and another pinch hitter. Jordan Sanchez, one of the Warrior freshmen, stepping to the plate. In the top of the seventh, excuse me. Buffen blew up by a score of 5-3. Welcome to split the season series with the Kamehameha Warriors. On their home field, pop
it to Vanessa
Va'a, showing the glove.
Really just
show me some glove.
Really, that girl is just something special, you know. She has soft hands.
She really
you can tell
is.
That, you know, her energy, you know, is brought by her talent, her physical talent. You can tell that, you know, whenever she makes a play, not just her own teammates, but the entire Punahou crowd basically rallies around her. That's the type of player you always want on your team.
And we're back to the top of the order for the Warriors. Leah Zablon, 0-3 on the day. She takes high.
This is Zablon, their number one hitter, looking to make something happen here with two down.
That's popped up. Third base side, Heaven Wong getting under it, and that is the ball game, folks. Buffen Blue victorious by a score of 5-3 over the visiting Kamehameha Warriors. Great win for the Buffen Blue, Kelly.
Oh, tell me about it. I'm a little bit, you know, taken aback. They really showed what they had to offer all around. Their hitting was, you know, electric. And their fielding, you know, it had a little bumps along the way, but they really pulled through at the end. That's all that you can ask for from a team. And I'm sure Coach Bobby Makahilahila is more than thrilled with the results of this game.
Right. With the loss, Kamehameha drops to 8-1 on the year. Buffen Blue are, I believe, 7-3 now. Something I should know. Something I should know.
6-3?
6-3, that's right.
6-3.
6-3.
Simple
well, I know
math.
Some teams in the league have played 8 games and some have played 10.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
Actually, I think then if that's the case, I remember looking at the stats, I think Punahou was 7-3 coming into this game.
That's right.
So, tomato, tomato right now. I mean,
glad one of us did their homework, Kelly.
I think not necessarily. I think I left my homework at work.
At the day job?
At the day job, yep. But, you know, congratulations to the Punahou Buffen Blue.
They electric.
I had someone just
electric.
Say.
Electric. Glad to know somebody's watching. All right, so we're going to put a wrap on this one. A great victory for the Buffen Blue with a victory over the number one team in the state.
Yeah.
You know, some timely hitting. Warriors got out to a two-run lead after four, and then the Buffen Blue came back with five in the bottom of the fifth.
That is just determination and the will to win by Punahou. You got to give their team some credit, and you can see it on their faces right now how happy they are. Just the hard work that they put in throughout the season really culminating this.
That was a great win, a great, great win for the ladies. So with that, I will once again remind you to check in this Friday and Saturday. It's a busy week for the mic. Third person, I refer to myself in the third person. For the mic, this Friday and Saturday, Clash of the Titans Volleyball, Punahou, Kamehameha, Hawaii, Santa Barbara, and MiraCosta. You want to check out that first night, especially when Punahou plays MiraCosta. Great match, a lot of good D1 talent on both sides. That matches on Friday, 5 and 7 p.m., Saturday, 3 and 5 p.m. Me and Tony McInerney on the first night, Coach Peter Balding, and junior school teacher Peter Schwengel calling the second night. So with that, we will call it an afternoon. Kelly Shee, thank you for joining me.
Absolutely.
A lot of fun.
Yep, it was a lot of fun. Thanks so much for having
me. Until next time. Thank you for watching Punavision. Aloha.